Can Charlie Cramer teach a complete nobody how to golf? If he doesn't, it may get him booted off the course.
That I would like to see.
Tee off with Sean Mack, Vince Strugala, Diane Libby Dixon, Ryan Dixon, Katie Scheffler, and Monte Stiffler in four.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. And then God created a lot of other things that weren't that important.
I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be seeing you.
But after a while, God grew tiresome of creating useless things. So he decided to create man, called him Adam. But Adam got bored living all alone. So God created a woman named Eve. God blessed them and said unto them,
Be fruitful and multiply.
The man and woman were quite fruitful for the next few weeks.
Yes! Where's your daddy? Where's your daddy? Where's your daddy?
But then both started to get really, really bored. When God saw this, he created something that would get man away from woman when they weren't being fruitful. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying,
Oh, every hole of the golf course you shall be able to play, but thou cannot have a par game playing this round. For if thou dost, thou and all future generations will be bugged by a woman every time he plays this game. So says I, the Lord your God.
And so man began to play, and on each hole had a par. And once he came to the last one on the green, a conflict erupted in man. He knew he had paradise in his hand. But a par game, that is something that comes once a millennium. So realizing woman would bother him forever, paradise would be lost, man cutted the ball into the hole, and the first perfect game was played.
Woo! Woohoo!
Unfortunately, man never got to play the game again because woman wouldn't let him out of the house on Sundays. And thus we begin our tale. 2 people, long after the first game was played, learned that it takes more than balls to play golf.
Where the hell is he? Jill, has he called?
No, not yet.
He's probably stoned out of his mind. Jim, what are you doing?
Hanging the Mitchell Lewis posters.
I can see that, but why is it crooked?
Well, I didn't think that...
Now there's the problem, you didn't think. I'm sure Mitchell Lewis, who is considered by many golf experts to be one of the top 5 golfers in the world, arrives at this golf course at which he so kindly decided to visit, and sees his picture on this poster, slanted on the wall. He's gonna say to himself, gee, obviously this golf course cares a whole lot about me. They even took the time to make my face slanted.
You really think he'd say that?
No, Jim, I don't. Now would you please hang these posters upright?
Gotcha.
This job's not worth $5.15 an hour. Excuse me, can I help you?
No, thank you. I'm fine. I'm just looking.
If he's not here in 5 minutes, I'm gonna kill him.
A wonderful feeling this is. You know what, Piercy? I don't see people anymore. I see dollar signs. And on their clubs, I see dollar signs. My vision is turning into one green heaven.
Yes, ma'am. Your father really built a successful golf course.
What? Did you say?
I said your father.
My father? My father? I told you never to mention that name again. It's all anyone says to me. Boy, your father built a nice golf course. They never mention me. Well, I'm running it now, and it's never been more successful. The best thing he ever did was to retire. And someday they'll see. Someday they'll see.
Yes, ma'am. I'm sure they will. And one other thing.
What is it now?
I really think that we should discuss your situation with the IRS and their investigation.
Miss Clark.
What is it?
It's your son. He hasn't shown up for work yet, and he's 47 minutes late.
Maybe he's dead. At least that way, I'd get some money out of him.
He's your son.
I jest. Just give him a couple of more minutes.
But I've already waited.
Shh. Now that's enough. Go downstairs and run the shop like I pay you to do.
Speaking of pay.
Goodbye.
$5.15 an hour.
Do you know what, Piercy? Why couldn't I have had a son with the littlest bit of brain and some talents? We own a golf course. He doesn't play golf. I wonder what that idiot is doing now.
Oh, man. Yeah. Whoa! That's the divine creation if I've ever seen one.
And where were you?
Hey, man, how are you? Let me tell you something. You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
You're right. I don't want to hear it.
Cool.
All because you're the owner's son doesn't mean you can come prancing in here anytime you want.
Cool. So, babe, what do you want me to do now?
Do you think you have enough energy to show our new employees how to run things?
Sure, where is he?
Where is she? Joanna, come here.
A female. Ooh la la. What is our new employee?
Joanna Von-Dong.
Hey, I think I might be coming to work on time from now on.
Now you listen here. Don't screw this up. This is the daughter of Claude Von-Dong, our club champion. And a very large donor.
I got you, man. I won't let you down.
Joanna, this is...
Clark. Ryan Clark. But you can just call me... Sexy.
Joanna, he's always joking like this.
Is this the owner's idiot son Daddy always talks about?
Hey, man, I'm not an idiot. I'm an artist.
Come on, Joanna, I'll go show you around.
Hey, man. Hey, Dick, what do you want me to do?
Just go do something.
Cool.
I get knocked down, and I get up again.
Fore!
Why are you yelling Fore?
You almost hit those people.
Those people were a mile away, Earl.
Now, I wouldn't say that.
You just hit your ball. Do you know, in the prefatory instructions for proper golf etiquette in the official rules of golf, players are admonished to act with due consideration for other golfers. As I'm sure you know, this rule is just about as flagrantly ignored as jaywalking. You ignoring your flying ball is not only serious, but potentially actionable. Legal precedent places liability on a golfer who fails to warn other golfers of a dangerous shot. Whether or not other golfers like myself can be held liable for the shots of a player in their group is still, well, questionable. But considering how clever some plaintiff's lawyers can be, I personally don't want to risk it. Well, thank you, Johnny Cochran. Why don't you just tell me the origin of the word, too?
Well, the origin of the word Fore is about as dubious as the origin of the universe. The latest theory has it coming from a 17th century British artillery warning, beware, before, warning soldiers for incoming flak from exploding cannon shells. How appropriate. An errant top flight is certainly as dangerous as an incoming chunk of hot lead. From a player like you, could just be as deadly.
If you don't tee up, I'm gonna hit a ball right at your face. And the last thing you'll need to know is whether or not I said Fore.
All right, but if I get sued, you get sued, it's not my fault.
Tee up!
All right.
Fore!
What was that for?
I thought I saw a squirrel down there.
Excuse me, son.
Well, what do you want?
You seem to forgot something back here.
What are you talking about?
You forgot to replace your divot.
What are you talking about? I'd make that.
I think you're the one mistaken, son. Is this not where you hit your last shot from right here, son?
No. What are you talking about? You're crazy. I didn't make that.
You've been in the war, son?
Yeah, I was in the Civil War.
Think that's funny, don't you? Let me tell you something, son. So happens I was in a war. Happened in a small little country called Korea. You ever hear of it?
You know, I slept through that unit in history class.
You know, son, I fought for democracy in this country. There's people like you working for the Communist Party. You're trying to do away with it by doing things like not replacing her divot.
You know what, man? You're nuts. I'm out of here.
Listen to me, you punk-ass little kid.
Ah!
Get back here and replace that divot now. I'll blow your goddamn balls off and you can make divots hitting him. You understand me? I said you understand me. Then do it now.
Oh my God, he's gonna get him.
That's a good boy. Remember, son, democracy will prevail. And only you can prevent divots.
So, you like working here?
Do you think I like working here?
I don't know, man. I never thought it was that bad.
Listen, the only reason I'm working at this pathetic job is because Daddy thinks I'll get responsibility. And these stupid menial tasks they make me do, like folding shirts, and the golfers who try to touch and grope me. The thing I hate most about this job is working with pathetic, slacker, hothead morons to a million miles superior to.
Who would that be?
I freaking wonder.
So, you got a boyfriend?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I do. So if you even think of coming near me, I'll get him. And then he'll...
I bet. Let me think here. Beat the snot out of me.
No, I'll get him and then he'll sue you until you bleed. He's a lawyer, fresh out of Harvard, and Daddy's just crazy about him. Well, I think we've talked enough for the next decade or two, so don't ever speak to me again.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen a Mr. Charlie Cramer?
Charlie Cramer.
Yes. Yes?
Oh, yeah! He's out on the golf course. He's playing golf, I think. Do you want me to give him a message?
No. That's all right.
That's cool! Hey, I guess I'll be seeing you Friday night.
Not unless you have a reservation for Jean-Claude's.
No, but you have a reservation here, it looks, for karaoke night.
What are you talking about?
It says right here, man. Joanna, 8 o'clock.
That can't be right. I have a date with Steve.
But look at the good side. You can bring little Stevie here and you both can watch me sing.
I hate this.
Would you like another drink?
No, not yet.
Okay. How about you, fellas?
Thanks.
No, thank you.
Played a great game today, Jim. Great game. I'm almost there. Almost there.
Charlie, what is it?
I saw a dress that a girl I knew once wore.
What was her name?
Susan. Susan Harrell. And she was the love of my life. I was with the French Foreign Legion.
We were stationed in France, and one night I was walking the streets, alone, as usual. But there, I saw what looked like a poor street urchin. It was the first time I had ever laid eyes on Susan. Of course, she wasn't really poor. She was trying to get into character for a play she was in. But I didn't know that then. I walked up to her and said,
"Parlez-vous français?"
"I don't speak French."
"Neither do I."
It was love at first sight. We did everything together. Well, almost everything. When I got out of the Legion, we decided to go back to the States. One day, we were driving, and we passed this golf course. We really had nothing to do this day, so we decided to stop in and see what it was like. I'd never played golf until that day, But when I got on that tee, I had a feeling that was like, it was like, I don't know. It was just one of those feelings. I teed up the ball and I hit it. I couldn't believe my eyes. The ball just kept going and going. I think it must have gone 350 yards and it even hit the green. It was like I was meant to do this. I continued to play and I only got better. I was getting ready for a tournament this course was having. The winner would be eligible for the National Amateur Tournament, and the winner of that would be eligible for the PGA Tournament. I was far and away the best golfer there. I was a guaranteed in. Then, one night, it all fell apart. I had just taken Susan home and was very tired. Once home, I almost immediately fell into bed. As I was slowly drifting off into that great unknown of sleep, I felt wool touching me. So I pulled over my covers and I saw a sheep. Yes, a sheep. Someone had put a sheep in my bed. Before I could do anything, a man with a camera barged in my room and began taking pictures. My life was over. It was all over the newspapers and news magazines. The rest of my time was spent telling reporters that I did not regularly practice bestiality.
So, Mr. Cramer, have you had sexual relations with any other animals other than sheep? Aliens, perhaps? How about any inanimate objects? Tree stumps.
I had to even explain it to my parents.
But Mom, Dad, I'm telling you, I didn't sleep with any sheep.
Well, son, that's okay. When I was your age, I experimented with dogs and cats, and I turned out okay.
Here's a meat lollipop. I made them today. You might want to suck on one. You're good.
Then, doomsday arrived. Susan called me and told me she was leaving and going to California. She just couldn't take the stress anymore. I had the tournament the next day and I finished dead last. I didn't blame her. I haven't seen her in 4 years. Once in a while, I see a woman pass who reminds me of her. Oh, who am I kidding? Every woman I see reminds me of her, even some of the men. I never did find out who put that sheep in my bed, though. Now, I'm just trying to go on living. My golf game's improving, though, so that's a good thing. In a few years, I might just get that back, too.
But never her. Never her. Susan, Jim. Susan Harold was her name.
You know, Yuli, how they always talk about how Elvis lives. But one thing they don't understand, he's working as a communist spy.
Mm. You ever hear his music?
Filled with red subtext. Mm. He did more to hurt this country, Yuli, than all them Koreans I fought during the war. Mm. Mm.
Shh. Mm. Quiet. Sounds like Charlie's on the front perimeter.
Mm. I want to go check. Charlie! You know, Yuli, after all these years, what I feared most has finally happened. This great country we call America is finally being invaded.
At 0400 tomorrow, we're going out and destroy the enemy.
Hey, Charlie.
Yeah?
Who is woman on the deck over there?
That's Ann, Millie, and Loretta. I call them the divorce triumvirate. They come here almost every day looking for men.
But they never say anything to me.
Jim, they're not that desperate.
Don't you think, Charlie?
Cramer has a pretty nice ass.
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah, I kind of like that Jim. I think he could be a real animal. What? They're all the same in the dark.
Come on, let's go. Carpenter's group's almost in.
Oh.
Ah, shit.
What's the matter?
Claude Von-Dong.
My patisserie, you set my soul on fire. Hello, Charlie.
Why, it's Claude Von Schmaldong.
What did you say?
Nothing, just your name. Claude Von Dong, isn't it?
I'm surprised to see you here. I thought you'd be cuddling up with some barnyard animal. You like that kinky stuff. But at least you are good at that. Because I know that a one-legged blind prostitute could beat you at this game.
Well, at least I didn't get thrown out of my own country, you're a trash scum.
You're a pathetic American. Even Sven agrees with me. Don't you, Sven?
Yeah.
I'm sure that's not all you and Sven do together.
What do you mean?
Nothing, nothing.
Well, since there are only two of you, it looks like Sven and I will be joining you to make a foursome. Then you can show me those amazing golf skills that you showed me in the tournament 4 years ago.
You know, someday, I'm gonna kick your ass.
That I would like to see.
Claude, I could teach somebody your golf talent in a week.
Really?
Really.
Maybe you want to make a little wager? My animal-loving friend?
Yeah, I would.
Don't be stupid, Charlie. Smaldong's a good golfer.
I don't care. I just want to see him lose.
You better listen to your friend, Dr. Doolittle. In case you have forgotten, I have been the club champ for the past 4 years.
I'll bet you I can train somebody in a week, and that he and I can beat you and Sven in a round of golf. What do you think of that? Wiener schnitzel eating turd.
I like that. But two conditions.
What?
One, I pick the player.
Sounds fair.
And B, the loser will be banned from playing here again.
All right.
Good. I will find somebody the next day, and I will tell you. And Saturday we will have the tournament.
Sounds fine to me.
Change my mind, Sven. I don't want to play with these two people. Let's go play the back nine.
Probably a good idea. You two can have a little more privacy back there.
Jeez! My European ass.
You'd probably like that too much.
Come on, Sven. Let's go.
I hate that Claude Von Dong.
Charlie, why can't I play?
Will you shut up, Jim? I can't believe I did that.
Every time I see that guy, he drives me crazy. There's no way I can beat him. And now, I may not be able to even play on my own golf course.
But Charlie, if you only listen to me...
Will you be quiet? I just need time to think.
You all right, Charlie? Charlie, you left your clubs. You all right? Charlie? Charlie, where are you going?
Yuli, get your butt down. Guys like you in Korea would have a lot of assless men running around this country today. Mm. Let me see those binoculars. Come on. Come on, Yuli. Step on it. Give me. Let me see the binoculars. Come on. Yeah, it's all right. They're allies. I don't see no red. Okay, Yuli. Let's get moving. Come on, Yuli. Get your ass moving, buddy. Go. Step it up. Step it up. Come on.
What a wonderful idea, Claude. Now, we'll finally be able to get rid of that idiot. He managed to survive the ship incident, but he won't.
We just need to find someone for him to teach.
I've got it. I know someone who will be perfect. Why, you wouldn't know how to play golf if the club was screwed to his hand.
Who is it?
Why, my son, of course. He'll be perfect. And if we could just do something to him, to that bastard. Come on, break that. Yes. Oh.
There is that matter with the IRS. Maybe with the right paperwork, we can make it look like he was the guilty one. We could give him all that cash and make it look like it was payment. For the being in the back.
What would I ever do without you?
Oh, you would be a lonely woman, Catherine.
That I would, Claude. Now, let's go call my son and tell him the good news.
Okay, but first, how about a kiss?
Give me another one, Mel.
Don't you think you've had enough?
There's never enough to fill the void she left in my heart.
I've done better.
Oh, Susan. Susan, I need to talk to you about something.
What is it, sweetheart?
I'm leaving France. My tour duty with the Foreign Legion's over.
Next week? How can you leave France? What about us? Well, I know we've only been together for a few months, but I can't imagine my life without you. I love you, Charlie.
Then come back with me. Come back to the States. We can spend the rest of our lives together. You can continue to act. And I'll find work somewhere.
My life's here, Charlie. I'm a success here. My film career's just taken off. I need a better reason to leave France than we'll be together.
Susan, I...
Yes?
I love you. Can't you see I'm crazy about you, baby? You're the sweetest dame I ever met. You're the world to me. You mean everything to me.
Charlie, it took you leaving France to tell me that you loved me?
Kiss me now before I explode.
So, my lovely son, what do you think?
For that money? Sure!
I'll tell Charlie where to find him tomorrow morning!
Hey, wait a second here, dudes. Did I hear you say morning? Because you gotta understand something about me. I kind of have a rule. Well, it's like a kind of ideology that I just don't get up before noon, man.
Ryan. My Ryan. Just think of all the things you'll be able to buy with that money.
For that? Well, all right.
Good. Now get the hell out.
That was too easy.
Yeah.
Such a moron.
Before I leave, Kathleen, your golf course is looking a little bit shabby.
God, I never should have hired that idiot, Nelson. I don't know what he does with the time. Ah, I know. I'll go talk.
Okay.
All right, Uli. Let's see those communists get by this 10-foot hole, all right? Hey, come on, Uli. Let's go inside. Watch, don't step on your hand. Ouch! Ouch, that was my hand, Uli. Hey!
Nelson, are you in there? Come out. Fool's probably somewhere on this golf course. Who knows what he's doing? Nelson, are you in there? Come out. Nelson! Nelson, if you're in there, come out.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, for the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, Uli, does your star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
I love you, Uli. I love you, new little bugger.
I love you.
Oh my God, I'm never gonna play this golf course again.
Hey, wake up! Wake up!
Hey, man! Hey, watch out, man! I know karate, man.
Hey, be cool. Be cool.
Hey. Hey, I'm cool! Oh, man.
Are you ready?
Oh. Ready for what, man?
Golfing.
Golfing? Cool!
You don't remember, do you?
Nope.
I'm supposed to take you golfing today.
Oh, all right. That's cool. I'm ready.
Wait a sec. Don't you need something?
Oh, yeah, man. Thanks. I forgot about that. I'd just be blind.
How about your clubs?
Ooh, I like to go to them once in a while. Get down, get down.
No, golf clubs. Don't you have any golf clubs?
Man, I don't know. Let me check. Yeah, I don't think I do.
Are you telling me you don't have any golf clubs?
Guess so.
And your mother owns half of this course.
I think so.
Oh my God.
All right, first, tee up the ball.
Get ready to hit the ball.
Hey man, I'm just having like a problem here. We're like on the wrong frequencies. It's like you're AM and I'm FM.
All right.
Oh man, that's cool. I get it now. It's teeing up.
You're not holding the club.
How's this, man?
Maybe this won't be so bad after all. I'll take a swing.
Like the natural, man. It's gonna go right there. All right. All right, man. Hey, how far did it go?
Don't worry about it. Let's get moving. You got a lot to learn.
It's not that bad. You still have 4 days left.
I can't believe I did this. I was on my way to a comeback. I hate that Claude Von-Dong. And I know somehow he was involved in my incident.
It wouldn't surprise me a bit.
My life's a tragedy.
Actually, you do possess characteristics of a tragic hero, including the hubris that will bring about your downfall. But some of the characteristics and incidents suggest, well, more of a tragicomedy rather than a direct tragedy.
Will you just shut up? Does it ever, ever end with you?
What are you talking about?
You, just get the hell out of here.
I can see you're in one of your moods and do not want to discuss things in a logical manner. I think I will leave.
Buddy seems a tad disgruntled.
Disgruntled? A disgruntled idiot, maybe.
It's almost closing time. Do you mind if you finish up with a plastic cup?
No problem.
Hello, Charlie.
Hello, Susan.
It's good to see you again.
You never wrote back.
You never sent the right postage.
In 4 years, would it have killed you to pay the postage just once?
Charlie! Why must we argue?
Don't forget, I wasn't the one who left. There was too much baggage, is what you said at the airport last time.
Well, there was. I had too many suitcases for the plane, and I wanted you to take them. That's why I called, but you said someone else was on the other line and never came back on again. Well, I wouldn't have minded so much, but it was my cell phone that was billed.
Why did you come here, Susan?
I wanted to talk to you.
Talk is cheap.
Not in the whorehouse. Oh, Charlie, it's my career. It's a disaster.
I know. I've seen your biggest role. Extra number 22 in the postman. But at least you can't blame that on me.
It's not my fault. You lost that tournament, Charlie.
Then whose is it? The sheep's?
You don't even know why I came here.
I know why you came here. You came to apologize to me. You've come to say that you're sorry for everything you've done to me. And to apologize for ruining my career and my life. But I'm not the same young, innocent, naive person that you left. I've seen the world, and it's a mean place.
You haven't even been out of this town.
I watch the Discovery Channel. Go ahead now, Susan. I'm waiting.
Hey, buddy, I'd like to help you up, but your tip isn't that good.
Man, what's going on? Where have you been?
Golfing!
Yeah, right, man.
No, seriously, dude, listen. I, like, have no idea what I'm doing, but I'm doing it. It's like you try to put this thing in this hole.
So it's kind of like sex.
Kinda.
My God, Yuli. That's Ho Chi Minh.
Who?
All this time, I knew he was still alive. You know what this means? We're going to have to finally get rid of him once and for all. Let's go back and make plans. Come on.
Chance. Must be taking off with my dad, man.
My mom always said he was a good golfer.
What's your dad doing now?
He's dead.
Oh, I'm sorry. How did he die?
Well, my mom doesn't like to talk about it, but she once told me when I asked her, she said that he was playing the best game of his life. He was getting the course record, and then on the 18th green, one more. His last shot, he would beat the course record. He moved the putter back, and suddenly, boom! He spontaneously human combusted.
Oh my God.
I know. Well, let's keep moving on.
M16. Hand grenades. High C ecto coolers.
What do you mean he's improving?
It's the most amazing thing I've ever seen. At first, he was awful. But now, he's half decent. And by the time of the tournament, he may actually be competitive.
Thank you, Piercy. You may go.
May I ask you one thing, ma'am?
What?
Why do you hate your son and Charlie so much?
If you must know, when my son was 5 years old. He took a lottery ticket worth $5 million and he burned it. When he was 7 years old, Donald Trump called me for a date. He never told me he called. I never got a call back. He has been the ruination of my life. His entire 19 years in existence. Charlie. Charlie! 5 years ago, I had a cat named Snazzy. She was so lovely. So lovely. And she was poisoned. Poisoned! And when I went to find the body, I saw Charlie standing not 20 feet from her body, and he turned and ran. And I vowed that day to seek revenge on Charlie and pain on my son. Oh, here we go. There's he go. Damn.
Don't you worry, my little pussycat. Swim and I will kick their fat American asses.
But we have to find something, a weakness to exploit them with.
Drugs?
No, no. He's got the money. He can buy drugs, buy whatever he wants.
Women.
No. Wait! 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 I should have thought of it before. Not women. A woman. And the day before the tournament, she can give him. She renders him useless after she gives him some. And then Charlie will have the forfeit, the tournament. Now, we need a woman.
My daughter.
But will she do it?
If she doesn't, I will cut off the money and she'll come around.
Good. I'll have her brought up now. Nothing, Claude. Nothing can stop us now. Ow!
Oh, excuse me, little one.
You put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. You put your right foot in, and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your foot in, you put your butt out. You put your butt in and you shake it all about.
You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
You put your head in, you put your head out. You put your head in and you shake it all about.
You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Oh. Ah! Hey, oh man, hey, what's going on in
here?
Oh,
thank goodness someone came.
Hey, I kind of like this.
Oh, I was so scared, it was so horrible.
What was the matter?
It was a horrible slimy mouse, I swear, it tried to eat me.
Oh, you know, now that you mention it, I don't think mice are slimy.
Well, this one was.
Well, it looks like it's gone now. Guess I'll go.
Ren, wait, don't go. Stay here with me.
Well, if you insist.
I cannot believe Ryan's going golfing today.
Man, I think you know some people.
That is so true.
Got you now, you communist bastard! Get in there! Get in there, you cocksucker!
Now, I'm all alone.
Damn it! Be careful of that. I don't want it to fall. Mitchell Lewis is expected here any minute.
Mitchell Lewis is here!
Wonderful.
I bet that Mitchell Lewis is some good loving. I heard he isn't playing on our side.
Wouldn't matter to me.
Hey, oh, wait, give me 5 minutes. Three. What do you do? I'm Captain Clark, the owner of the golf course. Let me tell you what an honor it is to have you here. If there's anything we can do for you, please let me know.
Thank you very much.
Come this way, I'll show you where you'll be signing autographs.
Sure, you're the ones paying me.
This is true, but they do adore you. That's right. You might want to see your picture we put up. Okay.
That's my best suit.
It's a wonderful shot. Please, come this way.
Gotcha.
Hey man, what's going on here?
Maybe you should tell us, Mr. Min.
What?
You thought Vietnam was tough.
What are you talking about?
You ain't seen nothing yet. We're in for some fun tonight, Yuli.
Man, I'm an American.
Improve it.
I've seen every episode of The Simpsons.
Say the Pledge of Allegiance.
What?
You heard me. Ah! Say the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the Republic
from which it stands, not in. You
oh,
thought you
so
could
what?
Fool an American, didn't you?
Ah!
Well, you can't. Yuli, get the enema kit.
Joanna, just put the pill in Ryan's drink like I told you to. And tomorrow, he will barely be able to move, much less play golf.
Our next song is going to be done by three young ladies who affectionately refer to themselves as the Two-Legged Blondes.
Okay. No, not yet.
You're supposed to sing. And now we have Claude Von-Dong, your reigning and four-time club champion. But
that is right. Don't you forget it. I want to sing this for the Charlie.
Song of the night, we have Charlie, I Cry in My Beer Crate. Come on up, Charlie.
I'm gonna get you tomorrow, Claude.
Yeah, you get this, buddy.
Put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. You put your right foot in and you shake it all about.
You did it!
You do a hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. You put your left foot in, you put your left foot out. You put your left foot in and you shake it all about. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around.
Close your eyes.
You could slap me again, Oria.
No, I promise.
All right.
I wanted to talk to you about something. I'm really sorry about the other night. You just get me so angry sometimes, Charlie.
Let me ask you again. Why did you come here?
For you, Charlie. I've never stopped loving you.
It's been so long. I don't think we were meant to be together.
Charlie, how can you say that? Don't you remember us, you and me? When you asked me to leave France, you told me that you loved me. I left my career, everything, for you, for us. Now I'm asking the same of you. Leave this. Leave all of this for us, Charlie, so we can be together again. Charlie, I love you.
I love you. And I always have. But you have to understand something. When you left me, my life fell apart. I was devastated. I can't go through something like that again. I don't know. I just need time to think.
I understand. Understand?
But a slow glowing dream that you fear leaving our demon. It's a groove thing, do 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 do. It's a groove thing, oh yeah.
You know, I began playing on the course much like this one when I was 8 years old. The best years of my life.
Hey, man, you're...
Yes, I am. Mitchell Lewis, golf pro extraordinaire, and you're...
Oh, Ryan Clark, man.
Ryan Clark. I've heard about you. You have quite a day tomorrow.
Yeah, man. I don't know if I can do it.
You know, Ryan, about 6 years ago, I was climbing in the Himalayas. This terrible storm blew in, and I was most likely destined to die. But this ascetic monk, this mountain man, he came up there and he pulled me down off that mountain, and and saved me. I spent about 6 weeks in this hut and just recuperating, and as time would have it, we had a lot of time to talk. During that time, he nursed me to health, and I asked him questions. First of all, you know, dumb ones like, you know, why is the sky blue to, you know, how does Ed McMahon stay so popular?
Yeah.
But then I got around to the more serious ones, and I asked him one day, I said, you know, what is the meaning to life? You know what he said?
What?
Golf. Golf is life, and life is golf. I didn't understand it at first either. It was rather confusing, so, you know, he explained it this way. He said, you know, in life, if you're so busy focusing on the past that you can't act, and you're too preoccupied with the future, always wondering where you'll be, then you never take the time to do it right in the moment. But now, the only chance you ever have. Much the same way in golf. If you're worried about mistakes on the previous hole, hook, slice, and where you're gonna be in the next drive or next hole, you miss the only chance you have, which is right now. You know what else he told me?
What?
When it comes to golf, you and the club are one. You and the club are one.
Far out.
Ryan!
Yeah, man!
Who the heck you talking to?
Mitchell Lewis!
Who?
Wait! Hey, wait, man! I swear, he was here!
I told you, you better be cutting back on that shit!
But man, he was right here!
Eh. Hey, Joanne called. She said she's waiting for you over at your house. She wants you to show her your room.
I forgot! I better get over there. I might get some hanky-hanky.
Okay, drive safe.
Thank you. I will.
You and the club are one.
Hello?
You and the club are one.
I and the club am one. Thank you, man. Wherever you are.
You're welcome.
And this is Tom. You know, he's just like an action figure. He can fly, or he can come and kiss you. He can do lots of stuff, I guess. And, well, I guess this is my bed. If you wanted to try out the bed, you could have just told me.
Ryan, you are the sexiest man I've ever seen.
I know.
I think I'm in love with you.
Cool.
Kiss me.
Sure.
Wait. I'm gonna get a drink. Do you want one?
Yeah, I'll take a drink.
Wait.
Oh, man.
Alright, let's go. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Get up. Get up. It's game time. Wake up. Come on, let's go.
I can't believe this. They were supposed to go out, and I gotta come up here and wake your ass up again.
Jesus.
What am I gonna do now?
Morning, sweetheart. Good morning, sunshine.
It's your 6 a.m. wake up call, Ryan.
Time to go.
Man, wake up, man, oh man. I'm all wet.
And so it was. On this great day, the whole world anticipated the mythic golf match that was about to begin.
Claude Von Dong is all wrong. Gonna put him up against the wall and play with the schlong. You know what I mean? You gotta beat that boy. Grab the ball and jump, jump, jump for joy. G-O-L-F. Gonna be so deaf. You're rocking with the ref. Wanna be deaf? Wanna say what, go? Ryan and Charlie C, you wanna hit that ball so far over the tree. Take Claude Van Dong and you punch him in the face. You say what's up and you pray him with mace. Oh yeah, gonna put him on the ground. Gonna beat those Europeans all up the town, word.
Oh Bhagwan, please Ryan or Charlie ko golf game jita do. One of my government building jala ke raak kar dunga.
Good luck, Charlie and Ryan, and kick some European ass.
Hey, wait! Charlie Cramer's about to tee off. Come on, let's go!
Fine.
Are you prepared to lose today?
Hey man, we might win.
Shut up, Ryan.
Hey man, so I'm just trying to help. It's like a confidence boost.
You're right. Maybe you could. It all depends on the weather.
What do you mean, man?
Like maybe when hell freezes over.
Oh.
Just tee the ball up, Claude.
Go ahead, Sven.
Yeah.
Good one, Sven.
Yeah.
Don't screw it up.
Don't worry. Prepare to be amazed. Oh yeah, baby. Go, baby, go forever.
Yeah.
I be number one. Now it is your turn, Charlie!
Hey man, remember, it's like Rocky. It's like the eye of a tiger. You can do it. Okay, man. Cool. Cool. Oh yeah!
Not bad for a sleep lover. It's your turn, Ryan.
Alright, man. Prepared to be amazed!
Just hit the balls!
Let him fly, man.
Freaking little hippie.
Oh, well.
Okay, let's go!
Ah, oh, Sven.
It is no problem. I will hit the Vinny cut shot.
Yeah?
I played with the member here once. He showed me the Vinny cut shot. Oh, he hit it right up over the tree. I will do it now, he showed me.
Yeah.
My God, Julie.
Nothing I ever saw in Korea compared to this. It's Fidel Castro, Chairman Mao.
Who?
They're playing golf on my golf course.
This
must be a rescue mission for Ho Chi Minh. They will not succeed. I've been waiting for this day all my life, Yuli.
This is our finest hour.
Agent Bill Davis, IRS.
Wow, man, the IRS are actually the good guys.
And I have a warrant for your arrest.
For what?
Embezzlement.
What are you talking about?
Does this money look familiar to you?
I gave that to you, Ryan.
Oh, man, I forgot. I'm sorry.
I also brought you something else. Your husband.
Harold?
Dad? Son!
Oh.
Since you two were never divorced, Harold still owns half the golf course.
Oh no.
Say goodbye to your family, Mrs. Clark, because this is going to be the last time you see them for a very long time. And when the IRS is done with you, the FBI would like to ask you a few questions about kidnapping.
No! 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 I hate you, Harold! I really hate you, Harold! I hate you too, Ryan! I should have got divorced and never pretended you were dead and took that money! I'm ruined! No!
Charlie, man, because my dad owns half the course, that means you can still play here! Yeah!
No thanks, Ryan. I think I'll be going to L.A.
Cool, man!
Charlie, do you mean it?
Where's Claude and Sven at?
Why don't you make it easy on yourself and tell me where the missiles are hidden?
I don't know what you're talking about, you idiot!
That's exactly what Ho Chi Minh said just before we took care of him, isn't it, Yuli?
You're crazy! You are a crazy man!
Well, Mr. Castro, let me see you keep up the silent treatment when Yuli sticks one of your Cuban cigars up your ass. We don't like communist bastards, do we, Yuli?
No, sir, absolutely not.
God bless America. Land that I love. Stand beside her.
Don't you just love happy endings? Come on, baby.
Hi, I'm Sean Mack. In the motion picture Fore, my character, Charlie Cramer, was suspected of having sexual relations with a sheep. Although we portrayed this situation as a humorous occurrence, in real life, bestiality is no laughing matter. Over 5 million Americans are having sexual relations with animals at this very moment. Your neighbor could be in bed with his pet gerbil as you watch this. Bestiality is a disease that affects any sort of person. I myself had given my turtle plenty of mud before I realized that bestiality is wrong. For those affected, the only salvation from the darkness of fur is God. And God will set you free. And that's why I and a few other individuals have created the Church of Jesus, the Animal Slayer. Here you will learn to become free of the fur. Look at me. I've been animal free for 3 years, and I feel great. And you can too, in 12 easy steps that will change your life forever. To sign up, please call 1-800-11-NO-FUR. That's 1-800-11-NO-FUR. Thank you, and God bless.